मुल्क राज आनंद एम सी क्यू. ऑल दिस क्वेश्चंस विल बी बेस्ड ऑन मुल्क राज आनंद एंड हिज नॉवेल अनटचेबल. फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन जस्ट हैव अ लुक व्हाट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस कैन बी आस्क्ड. व्हेन वाज मुल्क राज आनंद बॉर्न? ही वाज बॉर्न इन 1905. वेयर वाज मुल्क राज आनंद बॉर्न? ओके, व्हेन वाज ही बॉर्न एंड वेयर? When in 1905, but if you are asked where, he was born in Peshawar. He was born in Peshawar. Where did Anand go for higher study and research in philosophy? Where did he go for higher education or for higher study? He went to England. He went to England. When did Mulk Raj Anand return to India? In 1932. Okay, when did Anand come to Mumbai? In 1946. Which was the first novel of Anand? This question is very important and it is always asked even in the competitive exams also, that which one was the first novel of Mulk Raj Anand. The name of his first novel was Untouchable. Untouchable was the first novel of Mulk Raj Anand. Mulk Raj Anand was born on 12th of December in 1905. Why did Anand start questioning the meaning of life and suffering even at an early age? All these are the questions. Why did Anand start questioning? Because of the death of his uncle, cousin and aunt, because of his living in poverty and squalor, and because of the British oppression in Jallianwala Bagh. In fill in the blanks you may be given, in 1925 Anand went to London on a scholarship to obtain a doctor's degree. Okay, the year was 1925. The next question is, during his studies Mulk Raj Anand fell in love with whom? It was Irene. During his studies Mulk Raj Anand he fell in love with Irene, but he could not marry her. In writing Untouchable, he was influenced by whom? In writing Untouchable, because there is also a speech of Mahatma Gandhi in this novel, so of course he was highly influenced by Mahatma Gandhi. Mulk Raj Anand worked for India's independence. Living where? Living in London. Okay, he was living in London. The next question is, he got the award of Padma Bhushan. Mulk Raj Anand also got the award of Padma Bhushan in which year? In 1967. And he also got Sahitya Academy Award in 1972. Okay, Padma Bhushan Award in 1967, and Sahitya Academy Award in 1972. What led to the awakening of the novelist? What led to the awakening of the novelist in him? His feeling for the suffering masses of India. It was his feeling for the suffering masses of India. The next one is, Mulk Raj Anand is one of the major novelists of Indo-Anglian fiction. Okay, one of the major novelists of Indo-Anglian, because Mulk Raj Anand is an Indo-Anglian novelist. Then next one is, Mulk Raj Anand has been rightly called the Munshi Premchand of Anglo-Indian fiction. Munshi Premchand of Anglo-Indian fiction. In his novels Anand combines Tagore's humanism, Bunkim's romanticism, Sharad Chandra's Boundless Human Sympathy. All these he combined in his novels. We find all these things in his novels. Mulk Raj Anand is a social realist. Why? He is a social realist because dirt, squalor, beggars, poverty, diseases, prostitution, all these different themes have been beautifully described in his novels. And he also portrays both the seamy and ugly sides of life very realistically. And Mulk Raj Anand has also been a keen observer of life, society and people. Anand's themes are socio-economic. Okay, his main themes of his novels are socio-economic. His novel Untouchable deals with the problem of untouchability and social injustice. Problem of untouchability and social injustice. In Anand's novels, women play minor and subordinate roles in comparison to men. Minor and subordinate roles of women in his novels. Anand's satire is aimed at social evils and society. Okay, he satires at social evils and society. In Untouchable novel, Anand not only presents artistically the problem of untouchability through Bakha, but also exposes ruthlessly the injustice, the inhuman treatment, the degrading humiliation and cruelty which stem from it. In Untouchable, what reveals the tragedy of Untouchable? The pollution episode, the molestation of Sohini and the throwing of the bread by the Hindu woman on the road. According to Mulk Raj Anand, what is the root cause of the tragedy of Indian underdogs? Poor economic condition. The root cause of the tragedy of Indian. What was the profession of Mulk Raj Anand's father? He was a craftsman. What led Anand to seek the meaning of life and death? Death of his cousin Kaushalya, death of his uncle Pratap and death of his aunt Devaki. That he tried to seek the meaning of life and death. Which incident did cast a deep impact on Anand? The Jallianwala Bagh. This incident cast a deep impact on Anand. Then next important question, who had a lasting influence on Anand? Philosopher and poet Mr. Iqbal had a lasting influence on Anand. When did Anand meet Mr. Iqbal? At Khalsa College, Amritsar. He met him there. In 1925, why did Anand go to London to earn the degree of doctorate? Where did Anand write Untouchable? Where did Anand write Untouchable? At Sabarmati Ashram. Okay, it was at Sabarmati Ashram Anand wrote his first novel Untouchable. Where did Anand write his second novel? Okay, Kuli. Kuli was the second novel of Mulk Raj Anand and it was written in England. Kuli was written in England. Whose founder is Mulk Raj Anand considered? Progressive Writers Association. Progressive Writers Association. What did Anand do in Progressive Writers Movement? He freely expressed his views against fascism and imperialism. who is known as the founder of progressive writers movement? It was Mulk Raj Anand. He was known as the founder of progressive writers movement. Which novel is Anand's latest novel? Morning Face. Morning Face is his latest novel. Then next important is, which chief qualities had Anand got? What chief qualities had Anand got? He was generous quietly. He had sense of drama and fun, and he was also aware about the miseries of his fellows. Then 55, who is the creator of most of our problems according to Anand? Who is the creator of most of our problems according to Anand? Man himself. Man himself is the creator of most of our problems according to Anand. While facing miseries, what should a man do? According to Anand, he should work out for his own solution through his writings and through his preachings. Then, why was Anand awarded by the International Peace Prize? He was awarded by the International Peace Prize, but why? What was the reason? For promoting understanding among the masses. For promoting understanding among the masses. When did Anand receive Padma Bhushan? He received Padma Bhushan in 1967. What is the main quality of Anand's optimism? He is capable to move the most pessimistic man to action. And this was the main quality of his optimism, that he was capable to move the most pessimistic man to action. Then next one is, when did Anand die? He died in 2004, on 29th of September in 2004. Okay, all these are not important. How old was Anand when he witnessed his cousin Kaushalya's death? He was only 11 years old. The next one is, Anand is known as an angry man. Mulk Raj Anand is known in literature or of literature as an angry man. What is the central theme of Anand's works? Humanism. Humanism is the central theme of his novels or of his works. How does Anand's fiction present him as a committed artist? Okay, he is presented just like a committed artist. Into what does Anand's philosophy plunge? In humanism and in socialism. Humanism and socialism. Because both are also the main theme of his novels. Who is innocently lovable and dignified in untouchable? Innocently lovable and dignified in untouchable. It was Bakha. What are the key notes of Anand's stories? Comprehensive and subtle pathos. Comprehensive and subtle pathos. What made Anand's art and craftsmanship suffer? It was purpose of reform and the desire for painting realistically. Purpose of reform and the desire for painting realistically that made his art and craftsmanship suffer. How did Anand break new grounds in the realm of fiction? By imparting new matter, technique, style and approach. 90th one is, to which were the bottom dogs being subjected? the socio-economic problems. The answer will be, to which were the bottom dogs being subjected? To the socio-economic problems. With what are Anand's novels saturate? With Indianness. Okay, with Indianness, his novels saturated. Which novel of Anand is known as the Epic of Misery? The Epic of Misery. It is Kuli. His novel Kuli is also known as the Epic of Misery. What is the plot construction for a novel or story? A systematic arrangement of incidents. What is plot? Plot is a systematic arrangement of incidents. The accumulated strength of his giant body glistened in him with the desire for revenge, while horror, rage, indignation swept over his frame. Here Anand is talking about which character? Of course, he is talking here about Bakha. Desire for revenge, horror, rage. It is written about Bakha. Which novel of Anand discusses the theme of exploitation of coolies working in tea garden at the hands of British officials? And the novel's name is Two Leaves and a Bud. Two Leaves and a Bud. Then 97. Which is the first novel of Mulk Raj Anand? Of course, you know very well, it was Untouchable. Untouchable was the first novel of Mulk Raj Anand. Marg, this question is also very important. Marg, a reputed journal devoted to the arts, has been edited by Mulk Raj Anand. Okay, Mulk Raj Anand edited this reputed journal. In his novels, Anand mainly deals with lower class. Whether it is Untouchable or it is Kuli, he always deals with lower class. Sohini in Untouchable. Sohini is the sister of which character? Sohini is the sister of Bakha. I regard untouchability as the greatest blot on Hinduism. This sentence occurs in which novel? I regard untouchability as the greatest blot on Hinduism. And this sentence occurs in Untouchable. Right? All these questions were based on Mulk Raj Anand. Now, the novel prescribed in your syllabus is The Untouchable. And let us have a look all the questions based on this novel, The Untouchable. Who was Lakha? Lakha was the father of Bakha. Who was the Jamadar of the sweepers? It was Lakha. Lakha was the Jamadar of the sweepers, and he was also the father of Bakha. What was the relation between Bakha and Ram Charan's sister? Lover and beloved. Who was Rakha? Bakha's brother. Who was a villain in Untouchable? Pandit Kali Nath. Who was Iqbal Nath? Sarsar, a poet. Who was a Havelidar in the army regiment posted at Bulashah? It was Charat Singh, a Havelidar. What was the relation between Sohini and Lakha? Father and daughter. Who was an English woman? Mary Hutchinson. Who was Waziro? A Muslim woman she was. Who was the alone Muslim woman character in Untouchable novel? It was only Waziro. What was Waziro's husband? He was a weaver. Then, which was the role in the novel as prominent as that of heroine Sohini? Sohini is the main heroine of this novel, Untouchable. Who was the playmate of Bakha? Chota and Ram Charat. Who was a wicked character? It was Pandit Kali Nath. What was the relation between Rakha and Bakha? Brother. Who is innocently lovable and dignified in Untouchable? of course, Bakha. Then, why is Anand's art called Twice Born? Twice Born, because his characterization follows East. As per great art of characterization, how does an author present his characters? Through action. Okay, through action, he presents his all characters. What is the quality of a flat character? A flat character always remains same throughout the plot or throughout the story. There is no change in his character. Why do the humble and generous souls of Anand's play get reduced to nothing? Because of long years of slavery they had. Who is Bakha? Bakha is the son of a sweeper. What was Bakha caught by? The glamour of the white man's life. So he was caught by the glamorous life of white man. How did Bakha understand the art of wearing trousers, breeches, caught only by fashion? What did Bakha want to be? Bakha wanted to be a sahib, just like white man's. Why did Bakha not speak anything when he went to rag seller's shop? Lest the rag seller should find from his talk that he was a sweeper boy. Who keeps on abusing Bakha? It was his father. Who calls Bakha the son of a pig? It was also his father who always called him the son of a pig. What promise does Charat Singh make to Bakha? That he will give him a hockey stick. That was the promise. Why was Charat Singh a god sent to Bakha? Because without thinking of caste, Charat Singh promised to give him a hockey stick. Who is Ramanand in Untouchable? Ramanand is a money lender. What did Bakha do when Ramanand shouted at him to clean a latrine? He joined his palm and agreed to clean. Why were the outcasts not allowed to mount the platform surrounding the well? Because if they ever draw water from the well, water will be polluted. It was the main reason. Why were the outcasts unable to have a well of their own? Because they had no money to dig a well. Who is Gulabo? Gulabo is a washerwoman. She is the mother of Ram Charan and she is the mother of Bakha's friend. Why did Gulabo wish to have jealousy with Soini? Why did Gulabo have jealousy with Sohini? Or why is Gulabo jealous with Sohini? Because Sohini was more beautiful, young and charming than Gulabo. Okay, Gulabo was jealous of Sohini because Sohini was more beautiful, young and charming than Gulabo. Who agreed to give water to the outcasts from the well? It was Pandit Kali Nath. Why did Pandit Kali Nath agree to draw water for outcasts? Because the exercise was good for his health. Okay, because that exercise was good for his health. From which disease was Pandit Kali Nath suffering? He was suffering from chronic constipation. Why did Pandit Kali Nath give water to Sohini even when other people were also there? Because he had an evil eye on Sohini. What did Pandit Kali Nath say to Sohini while giving water? To clean his courtyard of his house and temple. Answer will be to clean his courtyard of his house and temple. Why did Lakha keep on bullying his children? Answer is to preserve his authority, for he was weak and old. Then next one is, whom does Bakha think a model gentleman? Bakha think Chota as a model gentleman. Who was called the champion of all kinds of games? It was Bakha, a champion of all kinds of games. What was Bakha's principle in his life? That duty comes first. For Bakha, work was a worship. Who treated Bakha as a human being, not as a downtrodden? It was Havildar Charat Singh. What was Bakha told when he desired to go to school? That schools were meant for the babus, not for the lolly sweepers. Whom did Bakha request to teach him? Babu's elder son. How much fee did Bakha offer to Babu's son for teaching him? It was only 1 anna per lesson. That was the fee. Why did Bakha offer money or bribe to Babu's younger son? Because Bakha was afraid lest he should tell his elders. What did bitter leaf seller do when he was given an anna by Bakha? He dashed some water over it and purified it. How did shopkeepers used to give things to untouchables? Throwing at them. Shopkeepers used to give things to untouchables, throwing at them, throwing the things at them. What happened when Bakha was walking on the road while having jalebi? He touched an upper caste man on the road. Who helped Bakha when he was beaten in the town? He was helped by a tonga wala. In the novel, when did Bakha look ruthless, a deadly pale and living with anger and rage? Okay, when did Bakha look angry? When Sohini was molested by the priest. When Sohini was molested by the priest, we found for the first time Bakha angry. Why does Bakha say, why was Sohini born? Because he was hurt too much when she was molested, when Sohini was molested by the priest. Why did Bakha not tell his father about priest? Because Bakha knew very well that his father will not believe in him, or he will not take the favor of Bakha or Sohini, but his father would take priest's favor. For whom was Bakha ready to do any work at any time? It was Charat Singh. It was Charat Singh for whom Bakha was always ready to do any work. Why was Bakha attracted to Christianity? Because in Christianity, there was an equality to all. What qualities does Bakha have in the novel? He was ambitious, thoughtful, honest, obedient, kind, and even obedient to his father, and he was also a caring brother. So all these qualities Bakha had in this novel. They think we are dirty because we clear their dirt. Who says it? Bakha. Okay, it was said by Bakha. Why were chapatis thrown to Bakha? Lest one should get the touch of untouchable. So chapatis were thrown to Bakha. Who tried to molest Sohini? It was Pandit Kali Nath, who tried to molest Sohini. What did Gandhi advise to caste Hindus? To be kind and liberal for untouchables. What did Gandhi advise to untouchables? To cultivate the habit of cleanliness, to give up the habit of drinking, and to give up the habit of gambling. All these were the advices of Mahatma Gandhi to untouchables. It is not India's fault that it is poor. It is the world's fault that it is rich. Who said it? It was said by Iqbal Nath Sarsar. Why did Bakha want to meet the poet Iqbal? Bakha wanted to know about the machine he was talking about. So Bakha wanted to meet the poet Iqbal. Who called Gandhi a fool, humbug and a hypocrite? It was R.N. Bashir. What solutions does novel give in the last to remove untouchability, to adopt Christianity, to use flush system, to follow advices of Mahatma Gandhi? So all these were the solution given by the novel in the end. In how many languages has the novel Untouchable been translated? This novel has been translated in 20 languages. In 20 languages. What did Bakha hear about Mahatma Gandhi from the people in the meeting? That Gandhi is an avatar of God Vishnu, that Gandhi is an avatar of God Krishna. So all these things were heard by Bakha in the meeting. Why did Havildar Charat Singh like Bakha? Because Bakha was dedicated to his work. Why did Lakha borrow money from Ganesh Nath Baniya for the funeral of his wife? Lakha borrowed money for the funeral of his wife from Ganesh Nath Baniya. To whom does Bakha call son of a pig? To the priest. Why did Pandit Kalinath call Sohini to sweep the floor? Because Pandit wanted to molest her or wanted to violate her chastity. When does Bakha touch many people but was not beaten or insulted? When does Bakha touch many people but he was not either beaten or insulted? It happened in the meeting of Mahatma Gandhi. What happened when Bakha took Babu's son to his home after injury? Babu's wife scolded Bakha and abused him. Bakha was the victim of social injustice. That is the main theme of this novel, social injustice. Besides the issues depicted in Untouchable are, besides the issues depicted in Untouchable are religious hypocrisy of the caste Hindus, their feelings of inferiority to caste Hindus, the weakness of the downtrodden and the helplessness of the poor. Which solution given in this novel should be adopted first? Abolition of untouchability. What does the word Harijan mean? Most important question. Harijan means children of God.